Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I will show you guys how to use NVIDIA Canvas and create this kind of AI generated images. This image is not a real image. This is generated with AI using the NVIDIA Canvas. So I will show you guys how to create this type of realistic images using NVIDIA AI. But you guys need to have latest versions of NVIDIA card to do that. So if you have the card, you can go and download the NVIDIA Canvas. Once you download, you will see the NVIDIA Canvas icon, something like this. So let's open the application. Alright guys, so how this work is pretty simple. As you guys can see, we have a very simple interface in here. In here we have the tools, and top you can customize the view or open or save files. And on your right you will see these materials, which are basically natural elements which you guys can draw. I will show you guys in a while. And below we have layers. You can create new layers, same as Photoshop or any other layers. You can arrange the layers forward and backwards by adjusting the position of the layer top and bottom. And below we have these styles. So whenever you are drawing a painting, the style will be based on your selection. You guys can always change the style, or you can import your own image and use that one as a style. Okay, right, so I'm going to select this image for our first artwork. As you guys can see, when I select the image, the canvas is changing. So this will be our final output. In here, in the materials, you guys can see we have the sky in here, and this one is cloud and some forest and so on. We have a couple of materials. So we will be using these materials and going to paint in here. Based on our input, NVIDIA AI will convert that into real world image. Instead of telling you guys, I'm going to show you guys how cool is this. Alright, first I'm going to add some cloud in here. So I'm going to select this layer and select the cloud, and based on this style, I'm going to apply some cloud in here. Okay, just align. You can see the cloud is appearing nicely. You guys can bring the paint brush size a little bit smaller if you want, and I'm going to say Control Z to go back, and now I'm going to draw some clouds like this. Okay. Alright, looks good. And I'm going to create a new layer, and this layer is on top. Now I'm going to draw some mountains in here. Okay, for this I'm going to select the mountain, this one, and I'm just going to draw some mountains like this. Right, very simple mountain like that. And you guys can see our mountain is appearing, but it's not visible because we only have one thin line. So we can fill up all this area by just selecting this fill and then just apply here, which will fill up the mountains like this. Pretty cool, huh? And this look very dry, so let's add some forest. For this, I'm going to create another layer. You guys can use the same layer, doesn't matter. But if you have different layers, it's easier for you guys to edit that, okay? So I'm just going to create a new layer, and in here, I'm going to add some forest, okay? So I'm going to select the forest. Let's select the paintbrush, which is this one, and let's draw some forest like this. Okay, something in here, in this area, maybe some in here. Let me just cover up this area entirely, and this part also. Maybe a little bit more in here. Maybe some in here, also this area. Let's cover the mountain. All right, now this look cool. And now what I want is, let's say this look nice, but I want to add in some water in here, a river maybe. So I can select the river, or I can also add in a sea. But for this scene, I think river will be nicer. So I'm just going to select the river, and I'm going to create a new layer, and let's add in some water in here. All right. Maybe a little bit more. Let's bring the brush a little bit bigger. Let's add in water like this. All right, looks cool. And you guys also can add in water. You guys can use this to draw as well. So I'm just going to draw a line like that, a waterfall. And let's place it in here like this. All right. Now this one looks better. Maybe let's bring water a little bit more like that. All right. I'm going to add in some grass in here. Okay, and maybe some in here as well, so we can separate these two. And let's go back to the forest, and in here I will create a new layer behind the mountain. I will bring this behind the mountain, maybe here, and I will draw some forest in here. All right, as you guys can see, even if I choose this layer, when I do some changes, it's adding in the changes to other layers as well. So that's how the AI is working for now. Keep in mind, guys, this is still a beta version, but it's worked perfectly fine for me. And you guys can easily create background images. And also, as I said, now this image is based on this style. And you guys can change this style by selecting other images. You see, when I select this image, the painting is entirely changing. You can choose this one. You can see it's completely different. And you can see this one. So you can choose any of these images. These are readily available images. And if you guys want, you can bring in your own image. Let's say if I want to bring in my own image, just select the new style and you can browse. Let's say I want this image. Just open. Add the image. Once you add the image, you guys can find the image in here. Then if you select this, you can see the image is totally changed to our new style. And when you do things with different layers, you guys can easily switch off and on and see the layers. And if you don't like any of them, you can easily remove them as well. Let's say if you don't like this waterfall, you can completely delete this. And now we can add in a totally new style for this painting. Let's say you want to add in a sea or something. You can go into the materials and select the sea, create a new layer on top and draw the sea in here. So I'm going to make the brush a little bit bigger and going to draw a sea like this. And now again, if you guys want to add in a waterfall, you can go back in here and select the water. And I'm just going to draw a small waterfall like that. All right, pretty cool. As I say, guys, so if you want to change any of these style, you can switch back to this style and select the perfect style for your artwork. And I'm going to stick to this one. And there are more elements in here. You guys can edit hills like this in here, which doesn't suit for this artwork, but I'm just going to stick to these hills in here. So you can divide these a little bit more further, maybe a little bit like that. So we have some pop-up in here and you can add in forests. As I said earlier, there are rivers, trees, snow, which doesn't suit this artwork. Fog, maybe we can add some fog in here, which look too much. I'm going to rename this layer to fog. And just going to keep it like this. Unfortunately, in this application, you cannot adjust the opacity. All right, so once you have done, you guys can save this artwork in here, which will save its own native file. So I'm just going to select number one and save. And also, there's another option. You can go in here and export. So you can export as PSD files. Okay, so once you select PSD, and I'm just going to select the one and going to save. Now I will open my Photoshop, and in here I can open this PSD file in Photoshop, and you guys can see here this artwork and all these layers come separately. So you guys can easily select these layers by choosing these individual layers and edit them in Photoshop if you want. All right. Check it out, guys. It's really cool, and you guys can create backgrounds
very realistic backgrounds for your artworks using this method. Only thing is you guys need to have the proper card. As of now, what cards are supporting this feature? You can check that in the link under the description below. And this is an artwork I have done using this NVIDIA Canvas for a ground design. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.